let us continue with the next para. So he interrupted the lady and what he said, the doctors agree in ordering me complete rest and absence of mental excitement and avoidance of anything in the nature of violent physical exercise, announced Frampton, who labored under the tolerably widespread delusion that total strangers and chance acquaintance are hungry for the least detail of one's ailments and infirmities, their cause of cure. On the matter of diet, they are not so much in agreement, he continued. So Frampton, he tried to distract the lady from the open window and he told her that he was suffering from bad nerve and doctors had suggested him to take a rest and not to go or meet people who जो डरा देते हैं लोग या फिर जो डरावनी बातें होती है उससे डॉक्टर ने मुझे दूर रहने के लिए कहा है. सो ही वॉज लिटरली टेलिंग हर टू नॉट टू टॉक अबाउट एनीथिंग विच इज स्केरी गैस्टली क्रीपी थिंग्स, प्लीज स्टॉप टॉकिंग अबाउट दैम. सो फर्दर ही टॉक्ड अबाउट हिज डाइट. ही वॉन्टेड द लेडी टू टॉक ऑन सम अदर टॉपिक, नॉट ऑन द ओपन विंडो. वो उसको वहाँ से उसका ध्यान हटाना चाहता था. So what Mrs. Appleton said? No, said Mrs. Appleton in a voice which only replaced a yawn at the last moment. Then she suddenly brightened into alert attention, but not to what Frampton was saying. On the other hand, the lady was not at all paying much attention to what Frampton was saying. Usko bhi dhyan nahi tha ki wo kya bol raha. Uska dhyan pura window ki taraf tha when her husband would return. Here they are at last, she cried, just in time for tea. And don't they look as if they were muddy up to the eyes? Aur jaise usne window ki taraf dekha, who? Mrs. Appleton, she was very happy and she said, here they are at last, dekho wo aa gaye. Dekh ke aisa nahi lagta ki aankhon tak keechad mein bhar gaye hain, pure messy hoke aaye hain, dirty hoke aaye hain. Okay. So what she said was true, कि ये लोग आएंगे और कारपेट गंदा करेंगे. Frampton shivered slightly and turned towards the niece with a look intended to convey sympathetic comprehension. The child was staring out through the open window with a dazed horror in her eyes. In a chill shock of nameless fear, Frampton swung round his seat and looked in the same direction. The moment the lady said that her husband and her brothers had come, Frampton, he was shivering. He looked at the niece. Usne Vera ki taraf dekha, and Vera, who was looking at the open window, she was literally, her jaw dropped. Uska muh khula ka khula reh gaya, and she was just looking at the open window. Literally three of them were coming, वो सच में आ रहे थे. And when he looked at the Vera's expression, he tried to discover were they really coming. So he turned around and he looked at the open window. In the deepening twilight, three figures were walking across the lawn towards the window. They all carried guns under their arms and one of them was additionally burdened with a white coat hung over his shoulders. तो जब उसने टर्न होके देखा कि सच में वो तीन बंदे आ रहे थे और एक ने सच में वो वाटरप्रूफ व्हाइट कोट पहना हुआ था. They were carrying guns in their arms. A tired brown spaniel kept close at their heels. और जो कुत्ता था, जो डॉग था, स्पैनियल, वो भी आ रहा था उनके साथ. Noiselessly they neared the house and then a hoarse young voice chanted out of the dusk. जैसे वो नज़दीक आ गए तो उसमें से एक बंदा गाना गाने लगा. Bertie, why do you bound? He started singing that song, exactly the same song which Mrs. Appleton, the niece, told to him. Frampton grabbed wildly at his stick and hand. The hall door, the gravel drive and the front gate were dimly noted stages in his headlong retreat. A cyclist coming along the road had to run into the hedge to avoid imminent collision. ये गाना सुनने के बाद फ्रैम्पटन ने ना यहाँ देखा ना वहाँ देखा, जस्ट ही पिक्ड अप हिज हैट हिज स्टिक एंड ही रैन आउट ऑफ द डोर स्ट्रेट अवे इनटू हिज कार. ही जस्ट ड्रोव वेरी वाइल्डली. एक साइकिलिस्ट को आते हुए उसने देखा भी नहीं. द साइकिलिस्ट गॉट to know that the person in the car is going to hit him, so he got to the hedge. Hedge means boundary, जो fence होता है उसको जाके टकरा गया. Okay, so Frampton very very wildly he ran away from that house. बहुत डरा हुआ था, वहाँ से भाग गया कि ये भूत लोग मुझे मार ना डाले इस डर से. Okay, here we are my dear, said the bearer of the white Macintosh, coming in through the window. Who was that who bolted out as we came up? So the as soon as these people they came in, one of them so her husband inquired that we are here, okay, and who was that person who bolted out as we came up. Jaise hum aaye ye banda jo bhag gaya kaun tha wo. He could only talk about his illnesses and dashed off without a word of goodbye or apology when you arrived. One would think he had seen a ghost. So what Mrs. Appleton said, that that person was just talking about his illnesses and his doctor and everything he was talking about. I was not interested in that. But he just ran away. Not a word of goodbye, not any apology. I don't think so. I for a moment I thought he might have seen a ghost. मुझे ऐसा लगा कि उसने भूत देख लिया और डर के मारे भाग गया. I expect it was the spaniel, said the niece calmly. So what Vera said, what she interrupted in between, मुझे लगता है वो spaniel को देख के डर के भाग गया. He told me he had a horror of dogs. He was once hunted into a cemetery somewhere on the banks of the Gangas by a pack of dogs and had to spend the night in a newly dug grave with the creature snarling and grinning and foaming just above him, enough to make anyone lose their nerve. So what Vera told about Frampton Nuttall to her family, that फ्रैम्पटन टोल्ड हिम टोल्ड हर अबाउट हिज फियर ऑफ डॉग्स. वो डॉग से बहुत डरता है और एक बार वो ग्रेव में मीन्स जहाँ पे मरे हुए लोगों को चुनते हैं ज़मीन के अंदर, तो वो खुद उसमें जाके गिरा और खुद को छुपा लिया बिकॉज डॉग अ पैक ऑफ डॉग डॉग्स वर फॉलोइंग हिम. उसके पीछे कुत्ते लगे हुए थे, तब से वो डरने लगा. And so he might have seen spaniel, और spaniel को देख के डर के वो भाग गया. Romance at short notice was her speciality. Now you people got to know what is the real story. Actually, the story is nothing. There is no such mystery in the story. There are no ghosts in the story. It was Vera, the niece, who had created the mystery, taking advantage of the bad nerve of Mr. Frampton Nuttall. Frampton Nuttall की बीमारी का फ़ायदा उठा के वेरा ने ऐसा सीन क्रिएट किया कि वो सच में गोस्ट थे. दे वर नॉट गोस्ट, देवर लिविंग बींग्स, और आई शुड से देवर अलाइव. वो जिंदा थे, वो मरे हुए बिल्कुल भी नहीं थे. और दूसरी तरफ उसने झूठी कहानी बताई अपनी फैमिली को, दैट मिस्टर फ्रैम्पटन नटल वाज अफ्रेड ऑफ डॉग्स. उसको डॉग से डर लगता था बिकॉज थ्रू आउट द स्टोरी ही हैड नेवर डिस्कवर्ड एनीथिंग अबाउट सच दैट ही वाज स्केयर्ड ऑफ डॉग्स, राइट. So Vera was a girl who was specialized in creating romance at short notice. Romance at short notice means उसको आता था लोगों को फूल बनाना या फिर मिस्ट्री क्रिएट करना, राइट. सो शी क्रिएटेड अ स्टोरी. आई शुड नॉट से क्रिएटेड अ स्टोरी, शी मेड मिस्टर फ्रैम्पटन नटल फूल. उसने फूल बनाया फ्रैम्पटन नटल को उसकी बीमारी का फ़ायदा उठाते हुए. So at the end of the story, we have learned that we should help the strangers. We should not make fool of them. Unko hame fool nahi banana hai, unki madad karni hai, right? It was a fun story. Theek hai, humne enjoy kiya. End mein hame pata chala ki nahi, koi ghost nahi tha. Okay? But bachcho, we should not make fool ऑफ अदर्स, हमको दूसरों को फूल नहीं बनाना है, राइट? सो वी शुड लर्न आउट ऑफ दिस स्टोरी. ओके, सो आई हैव गिवन यू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स विच आर देयर इन द होमवर्क सेक्शन. प्लीज कॉपी देम इन योर नोटबुक क्लीन एंड क्लियर, इन क्लीन एंड क्लियर हैंड राइटिंग विद द नेम ऑफ द स्टोरी अलॉन्ग विद इट्स ऑथर. ओके, सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड इट. Please read this lesson and go through the video again and again till you understand. Thank you.